The first patient, subject 1, was a 54-year-old man, a former smoker, 20 pi, had stopped smoking 25 years earlier, presented with an epileptic seizure, figure 1. A unique 3 cm diameter brain metastasis was detected by MRI. Additional exams corroborated the diagnosis of a right upper lobe adenocarcinoma with mediastinal lymph node involvement and a brain metastasis, T2N2M1B, according to the current 7th TNM classification, in July 2009. The patient received stereotactic brain irradiation then a 4-cycle platinum-based chemotherapy doublet followed by thoracic irradiation, 42 GY. 9 months after the end of treatment, October 2010, the patient presented with tumor progression, a new 4 mm diameter right cerebellar brain lesion and a lesion in the right femur for which he received femoral irradiation alone, 20 GY. The brain metastasis was considered too small for stereotaxic irradiation. At that time, a mutation analysis was carried out on the initial tumor biopsy specimen which unveiled an activating mutation of EGFR Del19, P.Glu746_ALA750-DELENS. Second-line treatment with gefitinib was started in December 2010 with excellent tolerance and a clinical benefit. In November 2012, right shoulder pain led to detection of a new bone metastasis of the tip of the right scapula that was treated with local irradiation, 20 GY, in December 2012. Stereotaxic brain irradiation was delivered to 4 new brain metastases in January 2013. Treatment with gefitinib was continued but lung and right scapula CT scan-guided tumor biopsy specimens were collected in October 2013 following tumor progression at these two sites, Moscato trial at Gustave Roussy, 12. The molecular analysis found an EGFR Del19, P.Glu746_ALA750-DELENS, mutation as well as an EGFR Exon 20T790M mutation in the lung tumor samples. The EGFR Del19, Glu746_ALA750-DELENS, mutation was found in the scapula samples but not the T790M mutation, figure 1. After discussion of the case during the Phase I Molecular Tumor Board meeting, the patient was enrolled in the Phase I study of AZD9291, ORA, started in November 2013. He received a fixed daily dose of 80 mg. An excellent tumor response was observed with a partial response of the different lung lesions and the right scapula lesion showed stable disease. RECIST progression was observed at different tumor sites after more than 12 months of treatment. The patient was enrolled in the MATCHR trial at Gustave Roussy and underwent further lung and right scapula CT scan-guided tumor biopsies. The results of the molecular profile are reported in Figure 1. Significant HER2 amplification was found by CGH in the lung sample together with a persistent EGFR Del19 mutation. Intriguingly, NGS revealed complete loss of the EGFR T790M mutation, with a limit of detection at least of 1%. No EGFR C797S mutation was found. Neither HER2 amplification nor the EGFR T790M mutation was observed on the scapula biopsy specimen but the EGFR Del19 mutation was still observed. The HER2 amplification observed on the lung biopsy specimen by CGH was confirmed by FISH, 50 nuclei analyzed, average number of centromeres per cell, 3.16, HER2/chromosome-specific centromeric enumeration probe, CEP, 17 ratio, 6.65, DNA probe kit from DECO, figure 2. Given this molecular profile, the patient started a new therapeutic line with a combination of paclitaxel and trastuzumab in March 2015. The patient presented a stable disease on the lung lesions and the right scapula lesion after 6 and 12 weeks of treatment.